It is indeed truly an honor and a privilege to be alive today, to just bask in the presence of the Holy Spirit and in the Lord Jesus Christ. Almighty God, we thank you for this day. Almighty God, we thank you, Lord God, for your word, mighty God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you have chosen me, mighty God, to be your mouthpiece today. Father, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Mighty God, you are my strength. You are my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. This morning, I would like to speak to us on the topic, the sure, solid foundation. The sure, solid foundation. Everyone is a builder. We are all building our lives, our houses, on something. When everything is going well, there is financial stability, relationships are cohesive, and life is great, a weak or shaky foundation won't reveal itself. But how often is everything going great? In the real world, the challenges of stress, anxiety, problems, and struggles come at us almost daily, if not hourly. Those are the times when the winds are howling and the rain is beating down on our houses. The roofs are blowing off, so to speak. Those are also the times when we will become keenly aware of how firm and sure our foundation is or isn't. Your house is only as strong as its foundation. Any architect knows that a solid foundation is essential to any building. The foundation really is the most important part of a house because every other component in the house depends on the foundation. Once the foundation is laid, supports are put in, permitting the rest of the structure to be built. A foundation not only holds a house up, it holds a house firmly in place. It also impacts the alignment of a house. If the foundation is not level and square, the house will not be level and square. In many instances, the interior parts will not fit together properly and seamlessly. It's the same way. If your foundation is not right, your life will not be leveled and will not fit properly together. Jesus taught the importance of building on the right foundation in his Sermon on the Mount. He concluded his sermon by contrasting two builders, two buildings, and two foundations. This is what he said in Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 to 27. And he says, anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes in torrents and the flood waters rise and the winds beat against that house, it won't collapse because it is built on bedrock. But anyone who hears my teaching and doesn't obey, it is foolish, like a person who builds a house on sand. When the rains and floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will collapse with a mighty crash. Here we see Jesus explains the difference between a wise builder and a foolish one. A builder who is wise hears the word of God, applies it to his life, follows God's blueprint, and as a result, is able to stand firmly through turbulent times. However, because the foolish builder doesn't obey or apply God's principles and instructions, he is ruined when a raging storm hits his life. In this parable, Jesus describes the storms of life as a matter of fact. He does not say if those storms come. Twice, he says, the rain came, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. So we can be sure that our life's foundation will be tested and tried. There's no getting around it. The question this morning is whether your foundation will stand up to the test, or have we chosen to build on a firm foundation or not? What is your answer? As a follower of Christ, your spiritual foundation is vital to your life, both here on earth and in eternity. So this morning, family, I implore you, don't let anything or anyone crack or tarnish your foundation. Stand firm. Don't let nothing come in the way to make it seem like your foundation is built on sand. You have a strong, solid foundation, the Spirit of God Almighty. Following God and submitting to his wisdom enables you to build a solid foundation based on God's values. If your spiritual house, which is built in your hearts and minds, are solidly based on Jesus and his word, you can have complete confidence and assurance that no matter what happens, your soul is secure. This means grounding yourselves in and on Christ, the solid rock, every day, and making wise choices through the guidance of his Spirit before the storms of life come. Only in him, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, can we be assured that our foundation is rock solid. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 9 to 10 tells us, "For we are laborers together with God. You are God's husbandry. You are God's building. According to the grace of God, which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation, and another buildeth thereon. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereon." If you build on a proper foundation and with the proper materials, then there will be no carnality, there will be no doubt, no distraction, no discouragement, no anger, no bitterness, no unforgiveness, no resentment, no disappointment. There will be no division, there will be no weakness. How do you build a strong foundation? Trust the Lord. Trust him with everything that is within you, every fiber of your being. Trust in the Lord and know that the promises of God are sure. Abide in God's word, where you will see the power of God, the promise of God, the provision of God, and the presence of God all come alive in your life. Apply God's word to your life. Believe it, live it, trust it, apply it, and pray according to God's word. And have faith in God and in his word. As you build a firm spiritual foundation, continually focus on God to cultivate a strong, healthy spiritual life. It just doesn't happen overnight, and you cannot buy it. So what do? You have to invest time into reading the scriptures, the same way you invest time into doing all these other things. You have to invest time into reading the scriptures. Study the scriptures. Pray the scriptures. Seek the presence of God in every decision you make. Next, Inspect your foundation. What have you based your life on? Do you know Jesus Christ for yourself? Or is it because you hear other people talk about him? Do you have a solid relationship with Jesus Christ? Allow the Holy Spirit to complete access of your heart and soul. Ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to you any area that is in spiritual disrepair. Acknowledge and begin the spiritual repairs without delay. Focus on every area that needs attention. You also have to ensure maintenance. Remain spiritually vigilant and seek to do the will of God in your life. Be intentional to remain faithful to God. Be determined to listen to the Holy Spirit's prompting and to be obedient no matter what. Dig your spiritual foundation deep. Develop deep, lasting faith so that when the storms of life blow strong, your foundation will be secure. It takes work and investment of your time, your faith, your trust, and obedience. It's a sure, solid foundation that will never change, never give way, and never let us down. Almighty God, our hope and trust is in you. As we build our sure, solid foundation, we completely rely on you, mighty God, to survive the storms of life, the various challenges that come, the financial challenges, sickness, mighty God, broken relationships. But mighty God, because you are the rock of our foundation and it is built on you, we are confident this morning, mighty God, that our foundation will remain secure even when the storms rage, when the rain comes, when the flood comes, when the winds come. Mighty God, we understand they come to test us. So Almighty God, continue to strengthen us. In your name we pray. Amen.